guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video I'm going to be doing a luxury haul. If you're new to my channel, my name is Molly and I do like beauty and fashion videos. I post daily on my Instagram, I'll put my page here, so if you're into fashion inspiration, things like that, I post daily on there for ideas. Today's video I'm going to be doing a luxury haul, so I've got things from Louis Vuitton, Dior, Gucci. Yeah, these are things that I've picked up recently. I didn't buy this all at once, like I know some people can do that, but justify it all at once. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and if you're into all things luxury, please keep watching. So I'm basically going to do it in like consecutive order of when I pick them up, because that's the only logic I can think behind showing you these items. So first of all, I got a Dior bag. I got this probably about maybe even a month now. I feel like because of lockdown, my time is just going, like, just have no concept of time anymore. So I got the mini Dior saddle in the grand leather, because I was going to look at the smooth, but I decided not to get it because obviously the smooth scratches so easily. I have the Givenchy Horizon in the smooth leather and I've scratched it so much, like it's just so much easier to take care of a grand leather bag. So I got it in the mini size, and I was torn between the mini and the larger version, but I'm not sure if it's the medium or the large. So I decided to go for the mini just because I prefer mini bags. I'm quite small, and sometimes when I have a bigger bag it does kind of make me look even smaller. For reference, if you are interested in this bag, it doesn't fit the pro versions of phone. I've got the iPhone 11 Pro Max. I've got the Pro Max. Doesn't fit in this bag, which is fine because most of the time my phone is in my hand anyway, so it doesn't really matter to me. And I also got it with this strap. I'm not sure the name of this strap, if I can look it up a bit here. It's just like a canvas strap, is that what it's called? So basically the bag, normally I'll just like show you. Bag itself comes like this. I got this on Depop with the receipt and everything like that, so I was really happy because I didn't want to pay full price for it. If you've watched my videos in the past, you'll know that I'm not a fan of paying full price for luxury items, like from the shop. If I have to do it, if I can't get it any other way, I will. But it's a bit like when you buy a car, as soon as you pay full price for a car, the second you drive it out of that shop, it loses its value. The same with bags, the second you walk out of that shop, it loses its value. So you might as well get it second-hand, approved authenticity, I'll never say that word right, than buying it first-hand, unless obviously you're not certain it's authentic, then there's no point. So yeah, I got this strap. It's just got the Christian Dior logo on it, and it's like the canvassy kind of material. I always wear it like this. I'm not sure if I can even... No, that doesn't work. I was going to say, I don't think there's anyone white. Obviously, you can carry it like this, like that, you know. There's loads of ways, and for ages old, I'm the owner of that bag, so obviously it's all over Instagram, and I would recommend it because it's really cute, and I just think the saddle bag is iconic. It's been around so long. I think it first came out in like the 90s, and obviously they had like the monogram version, the canvas version, and this is the leather. So there's loads of different ways of styling it, and it just goes with so many pieces. Recently they've been really killing it. Like, I've got the Dior trainers, I've got this bag now. There's so many other pieces from Dior that I'm eyeing up now. Like, recently I've just been obsessed with Dior, never was before, but I feel like Dior and Louis Vuitton are definitely my favourite designers right now, and Balenciaga. Used to be more Gucci, but I don't know, I just haven't really. The Gucci hype was like massive in like 2017, 2018, when that Gucci gang song came out, but it kind of died down a bit after that. There are the odd pieces I like from there, but the bags and stuff I don't really like so much. Next up is a piece from Louis Vuitton. I also got this piece on Depop. I buy most of my stuff on there. Depop Vestiaire. Only one of these pieces I actually bought, no, two of these pieces I bought directly from the store, or like a Farfetch or whatever like that. Most of the things I do get secondhand from Depop or Vestiaire. What's the place called? Where did I get the shoes from? Oh my god, what is that place called? StockX. So I do get most of my stuff from secondhand places, as I said before about the value. So you guys know how popular this bag is, and I need to tell you, like, this bag is everywhere, and I do get a lot of use out of it. So yeah, Louis Vuitton have their new printout for some of their Escale collection. I'm gonna say Escale because it's French. I'm guessing it's Escale, not Escale. If I'm saying it wrong, I'm sorry. So yeah, I get so much more out of this. So I thought, you know what, I'm gonna venture into this new collection because it's gorgeous, and the tie-dye trend is massive at the moment, so it kind of goes with it. So this is the same, literally, probably literally the same. It's the 26 clutch, like the pouch. I don't know if it's it is a toiletry clutch. I know that a lot of people are like, oh, you can't, it's a bag, it's not a bag, it's a clutch, like, but it works as a bag. It's a great size, you can fit so much in it still in a night out, and it's not too big, not too small. Like, it's the perfect. I don't know why Louis Vuitton don't have like an actual clutch bag this size and shape, because it's not. All their clutches they have are so thin, whereas this is like the perfect width, so you can fit like a hairbrush and everything in it. If you are looking for like your first luxury purchase, like a bag, I would recommend getting your hands on either of these, depending, obviously. This goes with a lot more than this, but I would definitely recommend either. So yeah, this is a gorgeous colour for the tie-dye trend and summer at the moment. Obviously, everything's bright and things like that in summer, so I thought this would be gorgeous. And obviously, the like gradient on it goes with pink, yellow, blue, purpley, the light blue, so and then pink again. So obviously it goes with all them colours whenever you wear it. It's just a really gorgeous piece. The quality of it is amazing. I don't really wear it that much. I don't actually think I've worn this out yet, which is obviously understandable because lockdown. Maybe I've bought this out once. Literally, I've paired it with so many outfits, like in photos and stuff, because obviously, so my Instagram photos, and it goes with so many like tie-dye pieces that I've had recently for like styling purposes. I haven't actually managed to wear this out yet.
It just show you the
inside as well. It's just pink all the way inside. When I wear these bags, I do have seen. I have been thinking about getting. Do you know you get like bag liners? Because obviously, if I use these bags for nights out, if I like spill lipstick, I don't wear lipstick. Any makeup in here, I'm gonna be gutted. So I'm thinking about getting like a liner for this.
So you just got the pink lining in it. Pretty much the same. I'm trying to think, is there anything in this? This has got the nude. It's also got chewing gum in there, so lovely jubbly. So next piece I picked up was the Nike Jordans, and I haven't always liked Jordans. I didn't really like, I've never really been a fan of high top shoes. I don't know whether it's because of my height. Basically, I find the shorter the trainers I have on, so like when my ankles are out, I think it makes my legs look longer, so I kind of avoided high top shoes for a very long time. There were so many that I liked, but these were definitely the ones I liked the most. They are the Jordan ones, and they're in the retro. I think it's the retro style. So they're just the monogram. They've got the gorgeous logo here and a faux fur kind of lining on like the black bit. And obviously they did these in like a black and white, so it was just painted black and white, but I definitely preferred the texture of these ones. And I got these on StockX, and I think I paid about £500 for them. Originally, they retail for like 180, so it's crazy that you can just get your hands, like, if you can get your hands on a pair of Jordans straight out on the sale, it's so much worth it because you can sell them for so much more. It's such an easy way to make money of snatching something up quickly, like the Air Diors, for example. Like, if you were lucky enough to win that competition, like, you've profited like 15 grand. Like, it's actually crazy the money you can make through reselling traders. I got these in a five, and I just think these trainers will go so much. The streetwear kind of vibe that I normally wear, like these would definitely go really well with that, like with like a pair of baggy trousers tucked in, or just with jeans, or with like a t-shirt dress, that would be a cute vibe as well. Any black and white bag would look perfect with these as well. I just thought it was kind of more of a streetwear kind of trainer that I'd like to have in my wardrobe. So next up is a piece I got from Gucci, and I saw these on Natalie. I don't know if her name's actually Natalia or Natalie, but I'll put her out here. Natalie Curdle. Basically, I got these Gucci joggers, sweatpants things. I got these in a size medium, which is around 8 to 10 in Gucci. And they've just got this Gucci logo in red down the side of them, and they're super thick, good quality. I love like cream and like white, any colour like that. And I thought this was a nice way to have that kind of comfort zone of me only wearing like whites, blacks, nudes, while also having like a pop color. It really suits me, but I never wear it because I feel like red, it looks really nice on like darker skin, darker hair, but I don't really wear it much, so I thought this would be really cute. If I walk through, my cat just walked in.
She'll probably walk around the background in a minute. So yeah, I thought this would be really cute with like a pair of red heels, like a bodysuit, like a similar color, or just like all nude. And if I had a pair of Gucci trainers, it would look really cool with these as well, but I don't.
I'm probably gonna use that as an excuse to buy some now, but
yeah, so I thought this was really a really nice piece in my wardrobe to kind of add a bit of a pop of colour.
I also find with these, any bag that would go with it. So you can have like a cream bag that would go with this, or a red bag.
But also any red piece goes really well with the Louis Vuitton monogram.
And I'll show you here, like you can just see that goes really well together. Don't know what it is about red, but it just matches it perfectly. Okay, last piece is something that I've been sat in front of me this whole time, that I've been eagerly waiting to open, because I picked this up on
days at Monday from the new Bond Street store. I ordered it online and went and collected it, so I'm super excited. So still in the box, I have undone the ribbon, I had a little peek, but I haven't really got it out properly yet because I've been waiting to film this video. I've got my receipt with
basically like a thank you card, product care, the receipt, that's a gift receipt, and yeah, basically exchanges and returns, so we can unbox it together. I've wanted this bag for a very long time. It's been around for, excuse me, it's been around for quite a while, like a few years, but they've only recently redone the design of it because I had a few complaints, I think, with the old design. I picked up the Palm Springs Mini. Oh my god, it's so cute. I don't have any bags that are like a backpack, so that was my excuse for buying it, really, because I love the monogram print. Okay, can we not? Yeah, you can just sit there. So I love the monogram print because it goes with so much. As I was just saying, it goes with any colour, so creams, nudes, blacks, gulls, literally anything. Inside, I believe that's where the straps are. So let me just put this together so I can show you properly. So this is it with the straps on, and it's so cute. I cannot wait to wear this. As I just said earlier, I've booked Ibiza recently, and this is like the perfect bag for that kind of vibe. It's not too dressy, it's kind of casual, but it's so cute how small it is. I feel like it could fit a good amount in this. I think this is what's new. They've done like the padding on the back, and also the zips, I think, open a lot easier. The only thing I would say is that I always say this for Louis Vuitton, I've said it with bags I've had in the past. These zips just feel like so thin. Like when you're paying $1,500 for a bag, like you would expect to have. The metal just feels like plastic. I don't know if it is. No, I think it's metal. So there, this would just be so cute to chuck on top of a bikini, like in Ibiza, like pool casual vibes with a pair of sandals. And also you could like dress it up with some trainers as well, like a casual. The only thing I wouldn't have this bag for is like a night out, like I don't think it's that kind of vibe. It's definitely a casual type bag. The quality of it's really nice, the leather is super soft on it. The padding on the back would be comfortable, obviously that's the design of it, so if you're wearing it on your back, even though it's not going to be strenuous at all because it is a backpack. It's got these adjustable holes all down the back, so obviously you can adjust it to fit you. Every little detail on it, it's got like Louis Vuitton, like it's pristine. So yeah, I paid, I think, £1,490 for this. I'm not sure what that is in other currencies, but this bag is really hard to get hold of. The only reason I bought this from the shop is because it actually sells for more once you've bought it. I bought this from the shop because it was cheaper than buying it on Depop. On Depop and Vestiaire, this bag retails for like 2.5 plus. You're on one, Kat. So yeah, as soon as I bought this bag, I know that if I sell it, I'm gonna make more money on it, so it's definitely an investment piece. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please remember to like and subscribe down below. I post new videos kind of hopefully every week. I try my best to. If you did enjoy, please like and subscribe. I'll put my Instagram here if you want daily fashion inspiration, if you're obviously, because I'm not posting much on YouTube, so I definitely post daily on there. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one.